Hello, everybody. Welcome back to American Textbook Reading. My name is Brian Stewart, and in this lesson, we're going over Science Book 4, Lesson 13, Work. Oh, is that a good lesson topic? I don't know. But don't worry, we don't have to work during this lesson. We can learn about work, and we can learn about physical work is the subject of this lesson. For example, you will discover how to make work easier. Whew, great! And also, what are some simple machines? Okay, so let's begin. The first word in our vocabulary section is pulley. Pulley, what's a pulley? Well, a pulley is a device. When people say it's a device, it's like a simple machine or it's some kind of tool that you can use to perform some action. So a pulley is a device with a wheel. And the wheel is here. You can see the wheel is here. And a rope, and you see the rope sticking up here, right? For lifting heavy objects. So it's a device to help you lift heavy objects, right? If this is an object that you want to lift up and maybe move somewhere else, you can tie a rope to it, maybe tie another weight over here, and then you can use the wheel to pull it up, and then you can swing this part, and then that makes it a crane. You swing it over, and then you can lower it down to where you want it. And that's what a pulley is, basically. A pulley is useful for lifting heavy objects. It makes it easier to move them around. Okay. Next, we have lift, and I just said that, lift. Yeah, a pulley makes it easier to lift heavy objects. So lift here is a verb, right? And it means to do something. To do what? To move something from a lower position to a higher position. So if you have something down here and you lift it up here, you're moving it from a lower position to a higher position. So from a lower position to a higher position. And of course, it looks like this is on a crane, C-R-A-N-E, which is attached to a pulley on the crane, and they're lifting it up. Okay. Wheel. We saw wheel before on the pulley, but a wheel, of course, is also on a wagon or on a car. It's a round object. The shape of it is round. And it's a round object on a vehicle, but it can also be on a pulley, as we just saw, which lets it move on the ground. Of course, on a vehicle, the wheel lets it move on the ground because the wheel can turn easily. It's round. It's very easy to turn this way or the other way, depending on which way you're going. But it's very easy to turn it, and as it turns, it moves across the ground. So wheels were a great invention many thousands of years ago because they helped people a long, 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 long time ago do their work more easily, right? They needed to move something from here to there. Hey, if you use wheels on whatever you're using to move, it's a lot easier to move it. So wheel was a great invention. Wagon. Now, wagon, in this wagon here, you know, there's many different kinds of wagon. This is a wagon that the pioneers used to move across the United States and in other countries as well. But a wagon, of course, is a vehicle with four wheels, usually pulled by horses. Usually, not always, because these are not horses, right? Horses don't have those big horns sticking out of them, out of their heads. So usually horses are used to pull wagons, but, you know, many different animals, animal power was very important, of course, before the invention of the machine, and different types of animals were used for their power, for their pulling power. In this case, we have a couple of oxen, and of course, horses are also used as well. Actually, looking at this picture a little bit more, I'm seeing that the ox, they're not real. Okay, I was like, wait a minute, that ox's back is very shiny. It's not a real ox. Okay, so, but anyway, what we're looking at is a wagon, and we see the wheels are here. And of course, there's four. You can't see the fourth wheel. But a wagon is very useful, of course, for putting stuff in the wagon and then moving it from one place to another. Makes work easier. Next, we have a lever. A lever is another thing that helps make work easier because you can use a lever to move a heavy object. A famous A scientist once said, give me a lever long enough and I can move the earth. Of course, you'd need a lot more other equipment to be able to do that. But basically what he was saying is that his point was that levers are very powerful. And if you have a lever that's long enough and strong enough, you can move very heavy objects, objects that you think that are not, that are impossible to lift. So a lever is a long object used to move an object upward. Of course, you need a lever. This piece of board is acting as a lever, but you also need this to put the lever on. You need some point to get leverage to be able to put it on there. And of course, this has to be strong enough to support the weight of whatever it is that you want to move up. What does this look like, by the way? It looks like a seesaw, right? So you use a lever when you go to the playground and you use a seesaw. That's basically a lever. Next, we have a ramp. And ramps are very useful, especially for people who have difficulty getting around. Some people, unfortunately, cannot walk, whether it was an accident or it was because of the way they were born. And so, of course, we should help these people. And you see ramps in various places in our city. In this case, there's a ramp on the city bus. A ramp is basically a surface. It's like a surface at an angle that connects a lower level to a higher level, right? So if somebody's in a wheelchair and they want to get on the bus, they can't use the stairs. So this is a good invention that helps them on the wheelchair. They can just wheel the wheelchair up the ramp and get on the bus this way. Of course, we also see ramps at the front of every building. There should be a ramp to help people who are handicapped get into these buildings. We call this handicapped access. So ramps are very useful, not just for handicapped people, but also if you want to move objects, heavy objects, from a lower area to a higher area, it's very difficult to try to drag them over the stairs. It's much easier to put them on a wagon with wheels or some type of vehicle with wheels and push it up the ramp. That's a lot easier. And we'll see that idea later in the lesson. Okay, those are the words for the vocabulary section. Let's take a look at the first main idea of this lesson. And as I said before, we're taking a look at how to make work easier. So what makes work easier? Now, as we have seen from the vocabulary section, and I've already talked about this a little bit, that there are many devices or simple machines that make physical work easier. So the first thing we looked at, of course, was a pulley. And a pulley can help lift an object up. And this is another type of pulley. You see the wheel here, you see the rope here. And by using that wheel, it's easier to lift a heavy object off the ground. Next, we have a lever. And of course, as I explained before, a very common type of lever you can see on the playground, that's a seesaw. And so levers can also be playful things, right? You can play on them. But be careful, obviously. But they're fun to play with. But a lever can also help move things because it can help you move heavy objects off the ground, right? If you can't lift it with your arms, you can put a lever on it and you can either stand on the other side of the lever or put a heavy weight on the other side of the lever, and that will help move the object up off the ground. Next, we have a wheel. Of course, a wheel is very useful for making physical work easier because it's hard to drag something on the ground, but if you put it on something that has wheels, then you can easily drag it or pull it behind you. So a wheel can help pull heavy things. And last, we took a look at a ramp. And here's another good example. Before, we took a look at a ramp on a bus, and I mentioned you also have ramps in front of buildings. This is a very good example. You have stairs, which are typical, which used to be the normal. Everybody had stairs. But thankfully, there was a law passed actually in America that required all public buildings to have a ramp to help people who cannot use the stairs to also get into the building, because why should they be left out? That's not right, okay? So a ramp can move things from one level to another, from a lower level to a higher level. Okay, so those are some examples of simple devices or things that help make work easier. What are some other simple machines that also make work easier? We can see three more examples. Here we have a wedge. A wedge, what is a wedge? Is it an axe? Well, you think about the axe, the shape of the axe head, right? Now, I'm not a very good artist, I'm sorry about that, but if you have an axe, and I'm gonna, here's the handle of the axe, right? And you have the axe handle, and this is a sharp edge. If you turn that and you look at it like this, it looks kind of like a triangle, right? So now I'm looking at it from the top down, and this edge here is here, right? So this is a wedge, it's like a triangle, and you have a sharp point here, and it's thicker here because there's more force behind it, right? It helps to put more force behind the sharp edge if you want to cut or split things. And of course, that's why an axe is so good at splitting wood. You know, you want to cut the wood to put in your fireplace or for other reasons. Wedges are used to cut or split things in half. And that's basically what it is. If this is heavier, right, if you have more, if it's very thin, it won't have as much force. But if you put more mass, more weight behind the cutting edge, then it's easier to cut. It cuts with more force. So you can easily cut little pieces of wood or little logs with an axe. Okay, good. The next you see screw. Do not call this NASA. That is not correct, okay? A screw. A screw is exactly what we see here. This is the whole screw. This up here is the head of the screw, and this is the part of the screw that goes into the wood. And on the head of the screw, you see these grooves. Usually it can be just one line, but it's more efficient if you have two lines crossed like this, right? And of course, you have the screwdriver that fits into those lines, and it's easy to turn that screw to put into wood because you have two pieces of wood. How do you hold them together? Well, if you have a long enough screw, you can put a screw through one piece of wood, and it goes through the piece of wood and into the second piece of wood, and it holds them together. And screws are great. Of course, you could use a nail. A nail doesn't have these ridges. You don't turn a nail like this. You just, I'm not a very good artist. You just hit the nail, and it's just a piece of metal that goes in. But what if you want to move it? Then you have to take the nail out, and it's very difficult to take a nail out. But with a screw, hey, just use a screwdriver and turn the other way. The screw comes right out. So screws are more efficient or sometimes more useful than nails. But they hold things together, usually pieces of wood. Next, we have wheel and axle. That's interesting. I would call this a wheelbarrow. A wheelbarrow. Barrow. A barrow is just, you know, it's like this is the barrow and this is the wheel. And basically the barrow is, don't call it a barrel, call it a wheelbarrow. A wheelbarrow is a wheel and axle, and they help you move things. Because of course it has a wheel, it has the axle here that connects it to the body. And basically, it's a lot easier to move this. Imagine if you have like a lot of sacks of rice. Let's just use that as an example. You have like 5 heavy bags of rice, and you want to move them from here to over there. Now you can pick up each bag, oh, very difficult, put it on your shoulder and walk over there and back 5 times. Or you can pick up the bag of a rice, put it in the wheelbarrow, just right there, put them all in there, then pick up the wheelbarrow over here. This is actually like a lever, right? So it's easier to pick it up because most of the weight is on the wheel, and then you just push it over to where you're going. If you're going a long distance, that makes it a lot easier. So wheelbarrows are very commonly used where people have to move heavy objects, a lot of heavy objects, from one area to another. So it could be bags of rice, it could be a bunch of bricks, it could be bags of cement. Actually, you know, wheelbarrows are very commonly used in construction sites because you have to move heavy materials from one area to another. So that's what we call a wheelbarrow, or here they say wheel and axle. But don't say, do you see the wheel and axle? Don't say that. Say, do you see the wheelbarrow? But basically, it's a wheel and axle. But don't call it that. Call it a wheelbarrow. Okay, let's move on. It's time to look at the reading passage together. As usual, I will read it out loud. You guys repeat after me, or just think about the words in your head. You know, repeat along in your head. Focus on the vocabulary and try to pick up any extra words along the way. You guys ready? Let's begin. Work is how much force is used to move something. If you push or pull, an object and it moves, work is done. But if the object does not move, then no work has been done. A heavy box is hard to lift. A lot of work is needed. A pulley makes it easier to lift the box. Less work is needed. Whew. Okay. A heavy box is hard to pull. It's also hard to push. A heavy box is hard to pull. There is a lot of friction between the box and the floor. Remember in a previous lesson, we talked about friction, right? It's the force between two things, and it makes it hard. So there's a lot of friction between the box and the floor. It is easier to pull the box on a wagon. There is less friction between the wagon wheels and the ground, right? The wagon wheels turn, so there's less friction. There's still friction, but it's a lot easier. Okay. A heavy wagon is hard to carry upstairs. It is easier to pull the wagon upstairs on a ramp. Less work is needed. Sorry, I keep interrupting, but yeah, think about that. A heavy wagon is hard to carry upstairs. If you try to pull it up the stairs, you go, ugh, thunk. Thunk, right? It keeps hitting the stairs, and you have to have a lot of work to pull it up each stair. A ramp is much easier. Less work is needed. Okay. A seesaw is a lever. It makes it easier to move our friends into the air. Okay, but be careful about moving your friends into the air. You don't want to move them in the air too fast, okay? But a seesaw is a fun play thing on the playground to play with. Okay, that's the reading section. Let's take a look at how the information is organized. Okay, the organization here is main idea and details. As usual, we have a main idea up here, and then we have details down here to support that main idea. What is the main idea? The main idea is work is how much force is used to move something. Now, what we can see in the details is, do we need a lot of force or a little force? And we see some ideas of machines or devices that allow us to apply less work to do the same amount of work. That's kind of a strange concept, but to do the same object or the goal, we need less work to accomplish these things. So first of all, we have a beep uses less work to lift a heavy object. So what was the device? It's actually the first word in the vocabulary section that we use to lift a heavy object. To lift, remember, means to move from a lower position to a higher position. So if you want to do that, what device should you use? You should use, of course, a pulley. A pulley. A pulley uses less work to lift a heavy object into the air. Okay. Now, next, we have another example, a seesaw. A seesaw is a what? We talked about this. It is a type of lever. It is a lever. And with a lever, you can move a heavy object by putting weight on the other side. And of course, a seesaw is an example of a lever. Next, we have a wagon is hard to pull upstairs. Of course, we talked about, you know, thunk, thunk, thunk. You know, it's very difficult to pull a wagon up the stairs. And you probably don't want to do that because your mom or dad will get mad at you because you're kind of damaging the stairs as well. So don't do that. But if you have, there's two things going on that you can use to make that wagon easy to pull from a lower position to a higher position. What's the first thing? Of course, the wagon has what? The wagon has wheels on it, so that makes it easy. The wagon's wheels, but the wagon's wheels and what? Not the stairs, use something else that doesn't have, you know, stairs. It's smoother. It's like a smooth surface at an angle. We call that a ramp. So those two things. So the wagon's wheels and a ramp make it easier to push or pull the wagon upstairs, okay? So that makes it a lot easier to get a heavy wagon from a lower position to a higher position. Don't try to pull it up the stairs. It's very difficult and it might damage the stairs and the wheels of your wagon. Okay, next, if you push a box on the ground, there is what? There's, remember that in a previous lesson, we talked about this. There's a lot of force that makes it difficult, especially over a rough surface. Remember we talked about rough and smooth surfaces. If it's especially a rough surface, and most ground is rough, it's very difficult just to push the box across the ground. Because why? What is that force we talked about? That force, of course, is called friction. Friction. So you want to reduce the amount of friction, so you put wheels under the box, whether you put the box on a wagon or even a car, a delivery truck, it has wheels on it. So the wheels can move more easily over the ground because there's a lot less friction. So you don't need to have as much work, you don't need to put as much work or force onto the object to move it over a surface, because you're eliminating a lot of the friction. And that's why, of course, wheel was such a great invention, as I mentioned before. Okay, so this lesson is about work and how to make work easier, right? As we say, work smarter, not harder, right? So by using these devices, you are working smarter, not harder. And that's a good idea because you want to save, you save time, you save your energy, and you can get more work done. So work smarter, not harder. Well, work hard, but you can work smart, not so hard. Whew. Okay, good. So anyway, that's this lesson today, and I hope you learned some interesting vocabulary and also some interesting ideas about the machines that you do see around you every day. If you look carefully at machines, you know, a lot of times we use machines and we don't even think about how they work. Look at how they work. What are the different parts? Are they using levers? Are they using pulleys? Think about the elevator in your apartment building. It uses a pulley at the top. Interesting. So there are lots of different things that you can look around and see how work is made easier. Okay, well, I hope you enjoyed this lesson, and I hope to see you in the next one. Take care, everybody. Bye-bye.